Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Misa and today, if my cat stops scratching the scratching post, I will be doing a tag. Today's tag is called Meowing About Books and this was created by the BookTube Goddess and I think it was created in response to another tag on BookTube called Barking About Books and that was created by Eric from Break Even Books and I will link both of their channels down below. I wasn't tagged to do this but it was suggested to me in a comment on one of my videos quite some time ago so I'm gonna have a go today and I'm really sorry if you have tagged me in recent weeks for various kinds of interesting tags. I will definitely do the tags but I'm finding it a bit challenging to find the time to film this type of video at the moment so I will do it as soon as possible. There are 9 prompts for this tag so let's jump straight in. The first prompt is Catnip, an addictive book or series that you devour in one sitting. And for this, I chose a book that I read quite recently and it's called When You Trap a Tiger by Tay Keller. This was so special to me and I read it in one day. It is a middle grade book and it is about Lily who is half Korean. So she's moving back with her Korean grandma together with her sister and mom because her grandma is sick. And it has elements of Korean folklore, which I thought was lovely. And it also has a tiger, so it's perfect for this tag. The second prompt is Litterbox, a book so stinky you want to bury in the sand. For this, I think I might have made a controversial selection because I chose Sapiens by Yuval Noah Harari, which I DNF'd quite some time ago, at least 2 years ago. I actually enjoy books on anthropology and often read non-fiction books on that topic, but I had to DNF this one because I could not get along with the writing style. For a non-fiction book, I found it difficult to accept the statements that were being made in the book, but we couldn't tell whether they were fact or theory because there were no references. So I found that really hard to read. I just did not like the writing style at all. So I actually plan to unhaul this and I think it is in my house somewhere, but I can't even find it. I think I put it in a box somewhere so I don't have to look at it again. So I've literally buried it in a box, just like a cat. The third prompt is Scratching Post, a non-fiction book you keep going back to in order to sharpen your mind or your claws. For this, I've picked The Lifetime Reading Plan by Clifton Fadiman and John S. Major. In fact, the one I have is the new Lifetime Reading Plan. It's an updated edition from the original. I chose this one because I do find myself referring to it from time to time when I'm looking for a classic to read. And this book has over 100 summaries of books that we should be reading over the course of our lives. I found it to be a pretty good selection. It's quite diverse and it's presented in 4 sections split into different time periods of history and literature. And I do like pulling this out to plan my reading. The fourth prompt is Mouse, a short story or book that you like to play with then devour. For this I chose The Bird Said Nothing by Paul Jennings who is an English-born Australian author who wrote some of my favourite books from my childhood. This is a really short book and in fact I think it's only about 27 pages so you could actually classify this as a short story but I read it on my Kindle so it is available from Amazon. It's so short that I don't think I want to give away anything about the story but it is really quirky just like any of the other Paul Jennings books and it has a moral to the story so I highly recommend this one but it's quite a sad story so you probably want to be prepared before going into it. The fifth prompt is Hairball, a book that you liked on the first read but after the passage of time you find it makes you want to throw up. Okay, so for this I have chosen Moon and the Sixpence by Somerset Maugham. If you've read it, I think you'll know why I might have chosen this. This is a story about Charles Strickland who suddenly decides to become an artist and he abandons his family and just moves away and eventually he settles in Tahiti. But anyway, he's a pretty despicable person, but this story is supposed to be loosely based on the life of Paul Gauguin, the artist. So yeah, this was certainly a memorable read and Somerset Maugham is one of my favorite authors, but this character, Charles Strickland, is so awful. So I think it fits this prompt pretty well. The sixth prompt is Attitude, a main character that has the attitude of a cat. For this one, I could only think of one really obvious answer, so I went with Holly Golightly from Breakfast at Tiffany's by Truman Capote. Of course, there's a really famous quote from this book where Holly talks about herself being like a cat, so it's probably the most obvious answer for this question. Prompt number 7 is perfect. A book or series that is so perfect that you can't find any flaws at all. So I guess it's a little bit difficult to find anything that has no flaws whatsoever. But recently I read a manga series which became an instant favorite of mine, and that is called The Blue Giant by Shinichi Ishizuka. I wanted to choose books or series that all have English translations, so this is the one I went with. There are a few other graphic novel series that I enjoy, but they don't have translations in English yet, so I wanted to avoid those ones. The next prompt is his, your favorite horror or scary book. I usually don't really read horror or thriller books. The most I would ever read is mystery, maybe, because I'm easily spooked. So for this one, I chose a middle grade book, and it's called A Monster Calls by Patrick Ness, which is one of my favorite books. It is actually not that scary. There is a monster. It's a symbolic story, and it is about a boy whose name I forget right now, but his mother is dying of cancer. So it is about this whole journey of coming to terms with that. And the last prompt is Nine Lives, a series or author you liked, then was dead to you, but then you like again. I tend not to have these kind of phases with authors, but I have had quite a number of authors I used to read when I was younger, and I just kind of forgot about them. It wasn't like I disliked them, but recently I've been trying to reread a lot of the books I read in the past because I started this channel and sometimes I can't remember what the books were about, and I've read quite a lot of books that I have no idea how to describe because I just haven't got it fresh in my mind. So one of those authors is Jostein Gaarder, and he is the author of Sophie's World as well as many other books, and I'm actually rereading all the books that I own by him. I have about 6 books here. So I'm actually on the book called Maya at the moment. To me, I never got to a stage of actually disliking this author in the slightest because he's still one of my favorite authors. But it is true that I didn't read any of his books for at least the last 15 years. So I'm doing a big reread at the moment. But I realized that his most popular book, which is Sophie's World, gets mixed reviews. So I think I would like to talk about Jostein Gaarder more frequently because he does write really amazing, intricate stories. I highly recommend his books if you've never tried any, but don't start with Sophie's World because that book tends to put people off for tackling philosophy and making it accessible to readers. Which is not a bad thing, but it gets mixed reviews, I think, for that reason. My favorite starting point for this author would be either Solitaire Mystery or The Ringmaster's Daughter. I think they are my two favorites at the moment. Okay, so that concludes the Meowing About Books tag. Before I go, I'm going to tag a couple of booktubers that I don't think has done this tag, so please do either the cat version or the dog version, depending on which animal you like best. I actually like both dogs and cats, but right now I know that I come across as a huge crazy cat lady because I have 7 cats, but I grew up with dogs. I had 2 dogs when I was young, so I love all animals equally. So anyway, so I'm going to tag Mark from Booktime with Elvis, who's always been tagging me with his wonderful tags. Thank you so much. And also Tiffany from Loveless Degrees, who's always doing really interesting tags. So I'd love to know your answers for these questions. Thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you liked it, and please give it a thumbs up if you did. And please consider subscribing if you'd like to see more videos from me. And I will see you in my next video. Bye.